Hey, what's up everyone? I'm at my college, ready to take my last exam. I study graphical and digital media. I hope it goes well. See you after it. So my exam actually went pretty well. I'm very happy. I'm excited for the next 2 weeks because I have vacation, and the first week I will focus on video producing for YouTube, and the second week I go skiing. So yeah, I'm driving home now. I will eat a quick snack and then I can teach you everything about time lapses. See you then. I just finished my food and I'm ready to explain everything step by step. Now this video is part of a playlist dedicated to time lapses and hyperlapses. So if you aren't watching this video inside the playlist, there's a link in the description to that video in the playlist, and then on your right you can see all the other videos related to time lapses and hyperlapses, so I really recommend that. The weather is very dark today, so I can't take a time lapse of the sky because nothing is moving in the picture. So I have to time lapse a highway. Now I can't record my voice while I'm time lapsing a highway because there's too much noise there. So we will discuss everything right here, and I will show some videos and some b-roll from when I was recording next to that highway. There are two ways to create our time lapse. The first one is by filming everything and then speeding up everything in post. This is the easiest method. Then the second method is taking pictures every second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, and then adding all those pictures into one video afterwards. The second one is by far the best one for multiple reasons. If you want an in-depth comparison between those two, you can search for the video I have on that in this playlist, or you can click the YouTube card. I also highly recommend you to shoot your picture in RAW because that gives us much more possibilities in post. So yeah, to make this time lapse, we need an intervalometer to take a picture every few seconds. I use my cell phone or my laptop for that. There are some apps that can do that. Some cameras have a built-in time-lapse feature, or you can buy a separate intervalometer. I will link some in the description together with all my other gear and useful things for making time-lapses. I will now go over a bunch of settings and how they affect our time-lapse. If you're just interested in the quick settings or my settings for this current time-lapse, you can just skip to this time in the video. First thing is the interval. For example, if your interval is 1 second, your camera will take one picture every second. This is equal to times 30 speed. I will go over some intervals for some well-known time-lapse subjects. A 1 second interval is most used for a time-lapse of driving traffic, fast-moving clouds, or a drive-lapse like I used in the beginning of this video. A 1 to 3 second interval is for sunrise, sunset, slower moving clouds, and for crowds. And then a 15 to 30 second interval. This is pretty long because a 30 second interval means that 1 second in your video will be 12 and a half minutes in real life. That's very long. We use this for moving shadows, the sun moving across the sky with a wide lens, or for stars. For stars, we can even go up to 60 second intervals. Then for the focus, we always want to use manual focus, because we don't want to change the focus during our time lapse. Then the white balance, that's another story, because in general you want to use manual white balance. But if you're shooting, for example, the sunrise or the sunset, where the lighting conditions will change during your time lapse, you can shoot in auto white balance, but then you have to de-flicker in post. For the mode you are shooting in, it's the same story as with the white balance. In general, you want to shoot in full manual mode because you can adjust every setting then. But if there are changing light conditions, for example, again with the sunrise or the sunset, then you can shoot in aperture priority mode because your camera will adjust the shutter speed according to the amount of incoming light, so your image doesn't get over or underexposed. So then we came to the main settings, the ISO, the shutter speed, and the aperture. Your ISO should always be as low as possible because a higher ISO lowers your video quality. So my ISO will be at 100. Then for the shutter speed, for time lapses, it's nice to have a low shutter speed because it creates kind of a motion blur,
for example, when a car is driving by. Now, of course, the lower your shutter speed, the higher the amount of incoming light. So if you want to lower your shutter speed even more, you can use an ND filter. It just reduces the incoming light in the camera, so you can lower your shutter speed a few stops more. Then for the aperture, this controls your depth of field. When you have a higher aperture, a larger part of your image will be in focus. So this depends completely on your situation. I usually use f4 to f8. And just like with the shutter speed, you can use an ND filter to get a higher aperture if needed for your situation. We are shooting in full manual mode today. I will go over the settings that we use. A very important note is that our time lapse will take about 10 to 20 minutes to shoot in total. So my settings will be a lot different from the settings you use for example, a sunrise or a sunset. The subject today will be moving traffic, so our interval will be at 1 second. Our ISO will be down to 100 and our aperture up to f8. Then we just adjust the shutter speed till our image is exposed correctly. If you want a lower shutter speed to create a more kind of motion blur in your picture, you can use an ND filter so you can lower your shutter speed a few steps more.
Okay, so here we are on the computer. We will be using Lightroom and Premiere Pro. Of course, the first thing you need to do is to transfer all your RAW pictures from the camera to the computer and save them in a folder. Then we will import that folder in Lightroom. So to import your pictures, you can import right here, or you can go to File, my computer is in Dutch. Then go to Import Photos and Videos. Then you get this window. Then you go to the folder where all your RAW pictures are, you press Ctrl A to select everything, and you just you drag it to Lightroom. So here are all the pictures. You just press import, and then Lightroom will import all our pictures. This can take a while depending on how fast your computer is. Okay, so all the pictures are imported. Now what we will do is we will edit the first picture and then apply that to all the pictures. So I will double click on the first picture. Then on the top, we go to, I don't know what it's in English. I think it's develop. Okay, so we click that and now we have some options. How you will edit your picture totally depends on your situations, your light, your location, everything. What I will try to do is to make the clouds a bit more visible because the sky is just white or gray, and just give the picture a bit more color, make it a bit more sharp. So yeah, I will speed up this process and then afterwards we will continue. Okay, so I will not waste too much time on editing this picture because it's for a tutorial. So once you edited the first picture of everything, you just select it. It's already selected, but to make sure. And then you press Ctrl A and you synchronize them. Okay, you press synchronize. So you just let Lightroom do its thing. It will apply the settings you changed in the first picture to all the pictures. Once this is finished, we need to export the pictures. So we press Ctrl A, we right click, and we press export. Okay, then we choose a location for our pictures. Make sure you can find it easily. And after it's saved, we will go to Premiere. So Lightroom is now exporting all my pictures. After this, we will go to Premiere and we will create an image sequence from these pictures to make a smooth video. Then we will stabilize the video and make sure it's in the correct aspect ratios. Okay, so everything is exported now. It's right here in this folder. So yeah, we will now go to Premiere Pro to import all these images. So we go to Premiere. And we give this a title, time-lapse live tutorial. Okay, so we click OK. So here is our empty project. So you double click right here, and then here we are in the folder with all our images. Now you select the first image, and right here you make sure that image sequence is selected. Okay, so then we open. So here we have one file. It's a video file with all our images. Actually, it's an image sequence. So we want to create a new sequence from this. So we right click and we press new sequence from clip. This is our new sequence, but the aspect ratio isn't right. So we right click our sequence and we press sequence settings. Now right here we can change the resolution of our sequence. Now you can choose, you can either make this 2K or you can also make it 4K because the resolution of our pictures is very big. I will make it 2K now just because it will be faster for the video. So the frame size horizontal will be 1920 by 1080. Okay, it's 25 frames per second and we press OK. Okay. So yeah, now you see we only have a part of the image, so we need to resize it. So right here we go to effects and then we just scale out. So we reduce the scale, we zoom out, and we will zoom in till we have filled our frame. Now this is a good time lapse, but when we have a bit of motion in our video it looks much better. So what we can do is, instead of this, we zoom in a bit more. So this was just about right, so we zoom in a bit more. Okay, so then we make sure that this arrow is at the start of our sequence. We add a keyframe for the scale and a keyframe for the position, and now with the horizontal position we make sure the frame is filled. Okay, vertical. Again, we make sure the frame is filled. Okay, then we go to the end of our composition. So right here is the end, and now we change the position to the right, and then to the top you can choose. Yeah, you get what I'm doing here. Okay, so now we will have a bit of motion during our time lapse. So now there's one more thing to do. We have to stabilize our footage, but first we need to nest it. So we right click and we press nest, nested time lapse. Okay, so right now we can go to warp stabilizer VFX. We drag it to here. Okay, and now we need to wait till Premiere has finished analyzing this. Okay, so the warp stabilizer has done its job. The footage is now stabilized. This really makes a huge difference. So yeah, we are ready to export this. I will go to right here, press right click, mark out, then go to file, export, media, and then we just choose a location. I will choose my desktop for now for it to go fast. Okay, that's everything. And now we just export this and we wait till it's exported and we are done. Maybe you missed this at the start. This video is part of a playlist filled with videos about time lapses, hyperlapses, tips and tricks, transitions, ways to make it look better. If you're interested in that, maybe you are already inside of the playlist, maybe you aren't. So in the description, I will put a link to the playlist. And yeah, take a look and take care. Bye.